Hello. I will try to be kind of short because it's too late, but not so short. So today I would like to present myself as a member of the errands group. It's an art and architecture group that we have since 2007, and I will tell you why. And the subject that I want to talk about is the today's revival of an architectural idea called the Nation's Bow in Athens. And the idea to connect it to the architectural project Çamlıca Cami in Istanbul, that you probably know. So I will start with a little introduction about the Nation's Bow. In Greek it's Táma to Éthnous. It's a Christian-orthodox church which was planned to be built in return for Greek liberation from the Ottoman Empire. The vow has been expressed as a praying, actually. It was, Jesus help us being liberated, and we are going to build for you a large, majestic church in the name of the Liberator, Savior, Jesus. The socio-anthropologist, Dimitris Antoniou, he studies the long history of this unfulfilled initiative. So as he says, on July 26, 1829, the participants of the Fourth National Assembly pledged to construct the church, the Nation's Bow, in return for Greek liberation from the Ottoman Empire. Its imagined architecture would reflect contemporary conceptions of the new nation, its historical mission, and its place in the world. Here you can see the Fourth National Assembly logo. And yet, a lack of financial resources and wavering interest deferred the Bow's fulfillment for well over a century, until in 1969, the Greek military regime launched an architectural contest to at last complete the project. For the colonels, building the bow would signify the country's new glories, the dictatorship's capacity to rebrand urban space, and the triumphant merger of nationalism, the classical past, and orthodoxy. So nowadays, it's the same picture with the couple. Nowadays, the idea of realizing the nation's bow is back via an old couple that you see, who already created a corporation in order to collect money. Actually, they have 15 million euros, and they tried to collect more money in order to build the church monument in Tourkovounia in Athens, with the aim of building it in 2021, so it's 200 years after the Greek liberation. It's interesting to notice, actually, that this is like their corporation logo. It's copies like the Fourth National Assembly, but instead of having the goddess of Athena, it has Jesus. It's like... So, I would just like to show you here... Is it okay? Can you all hear me? Like, the distance is okay? Alright. Just a little trailer. They have this one-day conference. Saying the promise of Theodoros Kolokotronis, this is the national hero, hasn't been forgotten. These people that had liberated us with their own blood had a vision and the goal, the nation's goal.
Thank you.
I will show a very short part of it. It's like in the same one-day conference, they had this reenactment that I found very interesting of Theodoros Kolokotronis, actually. The national hero that you saw in the only film. I want to explain to the people from Germany that they don't know. So it's Theodoros Kolokotronis, and he's himself nowadays like saying the vision, which is all also about the nation goal. Similarities and potentials of relations. This project is in the beginning, so I will show you some of first material and ideas. For those that who don't know, this is the Çamlıca, the new mosque, which is being built in Istanbul, high on a hill on the ancient side of Istanbul, overlooking the Bosphorus. Squads of engineers and workers are constructing a giant mosque complex that will revive the city's Sultan Ahmed and the Suleiman mosques in size, but not necessarily in splendor. Scheduled for the completion on July 1st, 2016, the Çamlıca Cami mosque complex will be one of the biggest Islamic shrines to be built in Turkey since the founding of the Republic in 1923. I also think that there were a lot of objections, this is what I read, about the location of the mosque complex, because it's one of the city's remaining forest areas, so green areas, and in a way it was also connected to all these demonstrations at the Gezi Park, in Maria, no more about that. So I was quite interested in topography and power. So finding the best location for each project, the Nations Bowl and the Çamlıca Cami, it has like a lot of similarities, of course. The first one is being built in the Çamlıca Hill. It's 2068 meters above the sea level. On the hill there are 18 radio and TV towers. The hill is a touristic place. There is one restaurant made by City Hall and many cafes. Çamlıca Hill is surrounded by trees. It's a favorite picnic area in Istanbul. And the domestic and foreign tourists are attracted to it. Let's go to the Greek version. The Tourkovounia. Tourkovounia, like the enactments, is like the highest hill. It's called Tourkovounia, which is like the mountains mountains. The Tourkovounia are the tallest and the most extensive hill range in central Attica, dividing the Attica basin into eastern and western parts. The ancient name Athens Mos refers to the sharp peaks of the range, while the modern name Tourkovounia, as I said, is said to derive either from a Turkish cemetery during the Ottoman rule, or because the troops of Omar Pasha had their camp there in the last years of the Greek War of Independence. So let's go to the sketch. Here we have located on the slopes of the 2,168 meters Çamlıca, the basin, one of the highest hills in the city, the most complex will be visible from all over Istanbul. On May 29, 2012, Prime Minister Erdogan announced, "We're going to build a mosque over 15,000 square meters next to the broadcasting tower in Çamlıca." This giant mosque in Çamlıca was designed so as to be visible from all parts of Istanbul. And here we have the Greek version. You can see we have Lycabettus, which is in photos that we cannot speak to. Its height is 277 meters, but the nation's wall will be 338 meters high. The wish of the donators is that the Christian-Orthodox Church will be built on Attica forest in order to be visible from all over. A very large flat church of the Savior in Tourkovounia Hill will shine and be visible even from the islands of Saronikos. And the Parthenon will bow humbly in front of the cross. This is what they write exactly in the book. I really like these pictures. This is why I'm showing them to you, about this idea of location scouting in order to find the best place. So these are some of the pictures that are in the book also. So it's like the couple taking themselves a picture in the Tourkovounia Hill. And this is from the time of the dictatorship, actually, that they had already proceed in the foundation ceremony, but it never happened. So I'd like to talk a little bit about architecture, and I think because it's interesting that between the two projects, like in the final form that they have chosen is a very like traditional one. Instead, in the competition, they have like all these modern buildings or contemporary architectural buildings. And so I would like to raise this question, why we're going in this very like conservative architecture. And I will read you some things. So here you can see like the contest, the architectural contest during the dictatorship. Some of the proposals. And this is, interestingly, it's like a photo montage, as you can see, of probably a mixture of churches or, yeah. And on the other hand, we have this super contemporary architectural proposals for the Çamlıca Cami. And this is what it's been built, actually, the one that you saw in the picture. Sorry. I'll show you this small. Inferior flow. Many architects have been critical to the Çamlıca-Çamlı project, arguing it lacks originality and that its two female architects had designed an inferior clone of the 17th century Sultan Ahmed Blue Mosque. Sultan Ahmed is situated on the historic peninsula of the European side of Istanbul, across from the 6th century Hagia Sophia, a monumental Byzantine basilica that is now preserved. Over the centuries, Ottoman and Turkish architects tried in vain to emulate the Hagia Sophia in their mosque designs. Very interesting the way that they are presenting in these two videos the architectural prizes actually from the architectural competition. So we have the nation's vote in the dictatorship. This is the ceremony of the foundation ceremony. In Tourkovounia here. So this is the place that all like the projects, the architectural proposals that were being awarded are being presented. And I thought it was interesting to this is today, and it's the way. I actually really like the way that they demonstrate the various. It has the connection to the location that we were talking before, and also how they show like these various architectural proposals in this video. So first you see this photo montage, and then you have like the papers that he's holding in order to show the. So it's like the first prize, the second prize, and third prize. And finally he's showing like the one that is going to be realized on site. And so together with the errands group, we created this collage. It's like, let's say, it's Hagia Sophia's Çamlıca on the hills of Tourkovounia. So it has this idea of imitating these architectural styles from a church to a mosque, and then from the one place to the other place. And for me, it also comments on, building the Orthodox Church on the so-called Turkish mountain, but also the big idea of taking back Istanbul. And for the end, I will show you actually two projects in order to connect with what we would like to do a little bit and connect also with the space. So the one project, just to tell you that the group works with the remnants of the failure. So it's leftover spaces, leftover concepts, leftover visions, leftover practices, and tries to reactivate these failures through interviews, transportations, historical research practices, directly connected to them, or doing the least possible interventions, always preserving their abandoned and failed state as part of their history. This is one example of this kind of project. It's called the Relocation of Futuristic House. We found one of the futuristic fiberglass houses of the 70s designed by Nikolaos Xasteros, abandoned in Thrace, and the group transferred this found dwelling to Phalerus inside in order to exhibit it and reveal the story of the fiberglass houses. It's quite an interesting story because Xasteros, this architect, aimed to design a version of prefabricated and modular houses that could be set anywhere in the countryside. Setting up a production unit of his own and spurred on much interest from prospective buyers, he prepared the opening of his first exhibition in 1978, so this is the flyer of the opening. The whole plan failed when, on the same morning of the opening, a new law prevented the building of the prefabricated houses in lots with an area less than 4,000 square meters. So the futuristic dwellings that finally made it out of the factory were no more than 10, and they were the exhibition ones. And this is why we tried to like re-exhibit this dwelling. And the group tried to reveal the contribution of Xasteros fiberglass houses to a wider architectural genre connected to the development of technology, mobility and mass production, together with Buckminster Fuller and Matis Uram. And together with that, okay, these are the plans. It's this local dispute, so it's like anonymous architecture, but it's still connected like with this failure, let's say. Local dispute is a project that concerns a special construction discovered by a group in Mani Peninsula. The narrow house was constructed due to a dispute between two neighbors concerning their land and their possibility to build. The narrow house has been built around 1998 with a legal permission on a triangular shape of floor plan. Its narrowest side that we see measures 1 and 10 meters, and it is a two floors residential building. The story is that they built it in order to hide the view from the guy that is in the back. And it's like this in the front. After a long term dispute in the court, the house was demolished in 2009. So they lost the court after 10 years of pain. So we call it local dispute. Yeah, money. We call it local dispute, and also like in a way because money is a peninsula where controversies occur very often. We thought that the house could be characterized as a modern monument of the area, referring to the old towers of Mani built for battle between families. So we collected this information around the house while it still existed, then we made the video of the demolition of the house, and this is the way we presented. So I showed you this to actually try to understand how the group is connected to the nation's role as a failure, hopefully a failure, and the multiple unsuccessful planning of the goals, fulfillment and realization. This is the action that we organized in Tourkovounia. It was 2 months ago, and it's connected, as I told you, I don't know if it was the same people, like with the space installation. You could see the video right next. So the group organized an open-air talk at the area of Tourkovounia in order to discuss on-site the reanimation of the nation's role and its possible connection to the Çamlıca mosque project. And you can see this just to close with the idea also with the spaces that is, since we are here. You can see this idea of the hooks. I say again, it's called hooks for public talks. So the hook is used in order to hang furniture and objects that are used for the discussion of various architectural elements, urban environments in the city of Athens. People are able to unhook the chairs and the tables and participate in a discussion. This idea tries to recreate the outdoor informal talks taking place between inhabitants in the city spontaneously and in different corners using elements of the streets, the buildings such as windows, cars or railings. Often, the residents take out their chairs from their houses and after the talk is over, they bring it back home. These informal talks, the so-called in Greece pilanakias or little wells, referring to the shape of a round talk, are very common held, especially in the Mediterranean countries, and their subjects vary from everyday matters to important political issues. The hook is an object. As an object, it maintains this idea of informality and is used in order to help activate discussion in various venues of the city. So that was one, let's say, action on this series of the hooks for public talks dedicated in the nation's bow idea in connection with the Çamlıca Jami in Tourkovounia here. So this is everything I wanted to tell you. That they just stretch it out or like,
But yes, who proposed it?
It's this couple there called Ioannis and Katerini Anagnostomoulou.
The
old couple.
Ah, it was couple's idea, not the dictatorship idea. What was?
It was the first time was in 1829. The second time it was in the dictatorship. They did an architectural competition, and it was a big scandal because they spent a lot of money in the architectural competition, and then it was never built. So they ate all the money away. And now, all these years later, this old couple tries to build it actually very seriously. So I'm not sure if it's a
I mean, but also Seth Nectarios, strategic Aegean island, has many similarities with it.
Ah,
and it
really
exists. I mean, it's very.
Yes. Yeah. I think it's a huge challenge.
Yes.
Are there any remarks or questions or other comments?
Okay, go for drinks.
And we go to our day today, and then we welcome you tomorrow for the gender queer panel performances and all kind of crazy stuff that we're gonna share with you tomorrow. And hope you like the Thursday and looking forward to welcome you tomorrow. Thank you.